As inflation slightly eases, the Philippine government wants to keep that momentum by creating an interagency task force to monitor food supply in the country. Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno says he will be the committee's head, with NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan as co-chairman. Diokno says the focus now is on boosting agriculture productivity as food remains the main driver of inflation.
Yung kasi pagka parang nag-create ng committee pagka mag-import na, no? Ganun. Eh, minsan mali yung timing. Kasi magdidesisyon ka mag-import, tapos darating dito sa atin, eh, tamang-tamang nag-aani naman yung mga farmers. Umaangal talaga sila. So, dapat talaga i-forecast mo yung, there should be a scientific, science-based forecast. This will be a permanent committee. Ang trabaho nito ay yun nga, to come up with demand and supply situation.
Aside from the creation of the task force, Diokno says government will continue to implement programs meant to help vulnerable sectors cope with elevated inflation.
Napaka-importante rin, sabi namin, na since mataas ang inflation, siguro ipagpatuloy natin yung mga ayuda na binibigay natin sa mga kailangan. So, tutuloy natin yung Kadiwa. In fact, we will expand the Kadiwa program. We will continue the provision of fuel discounts, yung programa for the farmers and the fisher folks. And then, we will extend the targeted cash transfer program for 2023. Ano itong cash transfer program? Ito ay 500 pesos for 2 months. So that means 1,000 pesos for 9.3 million households.
Philippine inflation in February slightly eases to 8.6%. The Philippine Statistics Authority is seeing positive signs of cooling inflation, but warns we may not be out of the woods just yet. Our very own Warren de Guzman now joins us now with more details. Warren, over to you.
Hello, Carmina. Philippine headline inflation slowed to 8.6% in February, at the low end of the Philippine Central Bank's forecast range of 8.5 to 9.3% for the month. But data from the Philippine Statistics Authority show only one commodity group contributed to the slowdown in February headline inflation: transport, specifically lower gasoline and diesel prices. Core inflation, which strips out volatile food and fuel prices, accelerated to 7.8%, its highest level since December 2000, when it was recorded at 8.2%. Inflation in the National Capital Region accelerated to 8.7%, its highest level since December 2000, when it hit 9.5%. Inflation for the bottom 30% income households, the poorest families, stayed at 9.7%, as that basket puts more weight on food. That is 1.1 percentage points higher than the national average for headline inflation. Some economists are saying the February inflation data provides room for the Philippine Central Bank to ease up on monetary policy tightening. National statistician Dennis Mapa, however, says it is unclear if inflation will decelerate further, noting the difference between January and February was actually statistically insignificant. January's inflation rate of 8.7% was an over 14-year high.
As a consumer, I would want to see inflation going down. Ano? Pero tingnan natin yung datos, ano, yung PSA naman ay tumitingin dito sa mga datos. Although sabi ko nga, while we are seeing slight drop in the prices, particularly sa food, medyo elevated pa rin siya. Plus ang ating ibang commodity groups, as I mentioned kanina, 9 commodity groups, medyo may pagtaas. Kaya ito yung mga challenges, but we are continuously monitoring the prices of the different items. Like sabi ko nga kanina, yung transport natin, may announcement in terms of increasing prices of gasoline and diesel this week.
Actually, a good breather for us. If you look at the overall index, it was stable from previous month. We're on track, right? Probably to what Governor Medales said, that by the fourth quarter, my figures show that by December or November, we may see below 4% year-on-year inflation.
Well, the Philippine Philippine Central Bank says inflation will likely remain above its preferred range of 2 to 4% until the fourth quarter due to food supply constraints, rising oil prices, and more second-round effects such as wage and fare hikes. National Economic and Development Authority Secretary Arsenio Balisacan, meanwhile, says the government needs to do a better job addressing food supply problems. He says, and I quote, "We must rethink our strategies to combat rising food prices. The country's current high inflation is largely driven by domestic supply-side constraints. Agricultural imports were ill-timed, and food supplies have been inadequate. The solution is to get to the root of the problem, including fixing the bottlenecks along all segments of the agricultural value chain," end quote. Carmina, back to you.
Thanks a lot. Warren de Guzman there joining us on the line.